The purpose of this demo is to demonstrate a few simple practices which will help you in the setting up of selection structures in your programs. By adopting these practices early on, you can make your development proceed a lot smoother and have a better chance of avoiding common syntax errors that often lead to some painful debugging sessions. So as always, let's start with our template and set up some simple sandbox program that we can play around and experiment in. So here's my template, and I'm going to start by saving this file to a class called, let's say, Selection. I'll save it. It's saving it to the wrong name for the class. I'll say thank you and save it anyway, because in the next step, I'm going to do a global replace on this template main with the expected name of the class Selection. I'll do a replace all, save it, compile it, run it, even though it doesn't do anything. And now we've got a nice starting point for experimentation. So what's the motivation for this discussion? Time and time again, semester after semester, I see some of the most common mistakes that students make over and over again with selection. And one of those is just trying to write too much code at one time and writing their code from top to bottom instead of from the outside in. If you get in the habit of framing your code, such as we're going to demonstrate here, you can very much diminish the likelihood of making errors, such as unbalanced parentheses or parens, which can be really hard to debug when a due date is looming up on you. So let's say you need to write some selection logic in your code. Start simple. Start with a simple if and write a condition only, matching braces, and some placeholder code to show where the next logic is going to go. For example, let's jump down here to the computation section of our code. Here's an if, an open and closing parenthesis for our condition, open brace, immediately a closing curly brace. Inside of that, we'll indent the standard four or three spaces, and we'll do something like this. Logic goes here, TBD. There, that's it. That's the framework for a simple if statement. We've got matching parentheses, we've got matching braces. Will this compile? Let's find out. No, it won't compile. We've got an illegal start of an expression. There's one thing we need to make this compilable code, and we'll just put in a simple true placeholder stub for the logic that we don't know yet. So let's try to compile it again, and it compiles cleanly. So now we've got a working starting point for whatever code follows. All we need to do is substitute the actual logic that we need and put in the actual statements that we're going to execute in the true case. But we can see immediately where everything needs to go. Suppose this simple logic isn't going to be adequate for our purposes. Well, what we can do then is we can set up some placeholder framework for the logic that we actually want. Suppose we've got a three-way compound condition. Open close parentheses for the first condition, logical operator and, second condition, perhaps an or for the third condition. There. We don't know what's going to go in there yet, but we can fill this in bit by bit. Same as before, to make sure that this compiles, let's just put in some placeholder stubs for this, save it, compile it. Great. We've got a piece of working code here, and we can add the details later on. Suppose next, instead of a simple if, we need an if else. Well, that's easy. We'll just tack on else, open curling brace, closing curly brace. Let's put in some pseudocode, like so, for example. And now we've got the structure of a simple if else. We'll save it, compile it. Great, it compiles. And now again, we know that our braces are balanced. We've got some pseudocode in there for whatever is going to come. And notice that the nesting of the pseudocode, where the code is going to be replacing it, this nesting shows the hierarchy of our logic and makes our code just easier to read. Maybe we need to turn this simple if-else into a sequential if-else-if with several cases. No problem. We'll just tack on placeholders for that. Let's say we need a couple cases. We'll just add as many else ifs as we need. with their statement blocks, with opening, closing curly braces all the time. Empty condition, open brace, closing brace. And let's, for example, and add a closing else default case. Open brace, closing brace. Again, always, always, whenever you open a brace, close the brace immediately. There. Suppose we need some compound conditions in some of these. We'll just add the placeholders for those. As so. Do I know exactly what's going to go in here? No, not really. We'll add some pseudocode and some nesting. A little misspelling going on there. And I'll scroll down here a little bit. There, we've got the framework of a five-way if-else-if. We don't know what the details are yet, but we'll add them on later. Again, to test it, let's just put some stubs in here, some logical stub values. True or false, doesn't really matter. We'll save this, compile it, everything's fine. And again, we can add the details later. Because now we've got a working starting point, and we've got a little bit of pseudocode in here to refresh our memory on what we intend to do. Suppose it's time to go to our next class, or go to work, or go to bed and call it a night. We can put this code away, and as long as we've got it saved somewhere, we can open it back up in JGrasp and come right back to it. Suppose in the course of our algorithm development, we decide we need some nested logic. No problem. We just go to the appropriate branch, and we simply repeat the process at a different level, like so. Again, the same ideas as before apply, and make sure to nest your code at every single level. Anything inside of any pair of curly braces should always be indented, just to show the hierarchy of your logic. So what are the takeaway lessons from all this? First, make sure to always frame your code in this way before trying to write all the details. Write your code from the outside in rather than straight top down. If you open a brace, close it right away so that you don't have anything mismatched. Same thing holds for parentheses. Always nest your code, such as we've shown here, to show the logical hierarchy and make it easier to understand and follow your own code. And sprinkle in some pseudocode comments to help you remember your own thinking. Whoops, it looks like I forgot a logical placeholder there. Okay, I know this might sound a little preachy or soapboxy, but this kind of technique will help you avoid lots of common syntax errors in setting up your own selection. Things about mismatched or missing braces, parens, and so forth. I just see this over and over again and am trying to make this point. Once you're able to get your code to this point, your code will become a little easier to develop because it becomes a little more of the fill-in-the-blanks variety, a little less error-prone. And by the way, everything we've just discussed applies equally well to the switch statement and setting one of those up. So let's give ourselves a little more real estate here and go through the same mechanics for setting up a simple switch. So for example, a switch, let's say we're switching on some integer value, open brace, closing brace, and we can put in as many cases as we need to. So we'll always indent those. Let's set up, say, case 1, case 2, case 3, and we'll always add a default case for starters, unless we don't need one. And we'll make sure to indent and add the recommended break statement to all of these cases, like so. And there, now we've got the framework for a simple switch statement on some integer value. And in the same fashion, now that we've got this structure set up, we can add whatever details we need inside all of these cases, and if we need to later on, we can remove one or more of these break statements if we have shared statements and we need some kind of fall through. But again, Same idea applies for setting up a switch. Write it from the outside in, set up the framework, add the details later. Okay, that should do it for this demo on setting up the various selection structures.